here on the Owensboro Greenbelt trail, and I got my painting stuff with me. It's like 30 some odd degrees and dropping. I know I just got that new sketchbook for Christmas, but I didn't bring it with me because I'm just trying to do just some quick, and I know that's kind of not a good excuse. But here I'm going to put a high horizon line. That bush out there on that little peninsula is going to be in this third, like if you look at these as thirds. So that bush is going to be basically right there. And the shoreline come around to that third and around like that. And I have some of these foreground bushes here. A little bit of land there, a little bit of. And there's that island with a few trees. That opposite shoreline, which is not really going to show up much, but it's just back there, just as a reference. And then those taller trees in this third. I hope my battery doesn't die. It's kind of cold out here. So, and then there's the distant line of trees. This will all be kind of. Yeah, you got to make sound effects when you paint, you know. You know, like when you were a kid and drawing, you'd make car sounds or airplane sounds. Sure, everybody does that, right? Yeah. Okay, so that gives me a starting point.
Zoom in here a little bit for you.
Okay. Everybody does things differently. Some start darkest darks to lightest lights. I try to establish some of my darks right off the bat, just to give a reference to that. These are, you know, actually too dark, but it's easier to lighten a dark than it is to darken a light. Of course, I'm going to be struggling with stiff paint. On this cheerful day. That. You know, a gray day like today is a great day to study your neutral, you know, grays, you know, temperatures, warm and cool, you know, there's not a whole lot of contrast. The biggest contrast is going to be the reflection of the water and the sky and the water right here. So of course, as things go off in the distance, they get lighter and bluer. So that distant line of trees back there, it's going to be, I mean, you know, the values are so close right now because of the, you know, lack of sunlight and the overcast. So and a good way to try it is, you know, compare it to something you've got as a dark, you know. You can put a little brush stroke there to see if you've got it the right value and temperature. It's like right now we're not, or at least I'm not trying to paint anything definitive. I'm just trying to get it blocked in. This three-color palette really helps you to simplify. You know, you don't have to worry about you know, all the different colors on your palette. You just got the three primaries, and you can pretty much arrive at anything in nature with those colors. Because in nature, you don't have a lot of really bright, highly saturated colors. Got a little bit bigger brush. That's always a good idea initially too, is to start off with a bigger brush. Stay neutral, and then increase your saturation as you go along. And it definitely becomes more saturated as it comes towards you. Go ahead and don't be scared to put some color down. And by color, I just mean pigment, not a specific color. Because, you know, you get some paint on the canvas, it makes it easier to start manipulating it. If you starve your canvas of paint, you just end up making mud. Thin, you know, just getting so thin that you don't get any interesting things happening. See, I'm not, you know, I'm just mixing into the same pile basically, because with these three colors, and they're single pigment colors, you know, that's a cadmium lemon, a alizarin crimson, and ultramarine blue, it's almost impossible to make mud, because you can just kind of go back and forth, you know, go towards yellow, go towards red, go towards blue, and bring it back the other direction. You know, and also, you know, when you think about the foreground versus the background, things closer to you are going to be, you know, have a lot more contrast, darker, your darkest, you know, you're not going to have a dark in the background as dark as in the foreground. Pardon my sniffles. I rode my bicycle over here, and so a little bit cool breeze on my face. Okay. if you notice, it may not pick up on the camera, but the reflection of that bush, the bush is more warm, the reflection is cooler and lighter. So, trying to arrive at that. Thank you. clean me off a spot here. So I've pretty much used the same brush throughout the whole thing too. And like I got way off on that collar right there, and I mean it's probably a little bit of a waste of paint, but I don't know, it's good that you can experiment and kind of see what your colors are doing. I'm kind of, exaggerating the color a little bit. I try to mix as close to what I'm seeing out there. But, we're artists. We're allowed to change things a little bit. Actually, I think we're expected to. This lemon yellow, it's pretty good at going towards warm. It's not nearly as warm as using the CAD yellow medium, but I mean, like I say, out here in nature there's really no bright fluorescent, kind of colors, which that's leans more towards, but you can really neutralize it. Scraped into it and brought up just pure pigment there. And try to get into the habit of just putting a brush stroke down and letting it sit there. I'm just as bad as everybody else. You'd sit there and try to dab at it, and that's just. Not the best way to come in here and lay these darks down. That lets you play off those darks to build some contrast with your lighter lights. Throw just a little bit of a reflection in the water back here, just to kind of take your eye back a little bit. those reflections here are going to be darker than the light up here. So I just want to make sure you pay attention to things like that. Put a little indications of some trees over here on the right. This liner brush, which I don't use too often, but just to interest over here. Okay, here's is the finished painting, a 5x7. Nice view out there. So, I think we got a snowstorm getting ready to blow in, and I'm gonna pack up here and ride back home. It's about 5 miles away, which not too bad. Just a great day to be out. Thanks for tuning in, and I'll see you in my next video.